Hello everyone. In today's class, we are going to solve one more problem of nut, bolt and washer combination. Let's begin with the problem. Draw two scale 1:1, the front view, top view and side view of a hexagonal headed bolt of dia 25 mm with hexagonal nut and washer, keeping the axis parallel to VP and HP. So in this question, first we will draw its front view, then its side view, then top view, and we will focus on hexagonal headed bolt part first, then we'll project its nut, and then we'll add washer. Now we have to calculate all standard dimensions for 25 mm. Starting with D, dia 25 mm, then next is 0.8 of D, 0.8D is 20 mm, then we have 1.5D, 1.5D is for its radius of chamfering on central faces of hexagonal headed bolt or nut. So 1.5D is 37.5 mm, is equals to R for construction work. Next 2D, 2D is 50 mm, then we have threaded length X, 2D plus 6, 56 mm, and L, length of the bolt, 2D equals to 100 mm. Right, so using these standard dimensions, now we have to start its front view. Now we are going to use 2D method for construction. So we will start from its front view. We'll draw its front view of hexagonal headed part first, then we'll project its side view, and before that we'll construct its nut. So hexagonal head somewhere here, then hexagonal nut, then using these two things we'll project its side view, then using side view and front view we are going to project its top view. So for construction of hexagonal head of the bolt, first is I am drawing lines parallel to vertical axis from its end. End means from the last end of the bolt. So from this point, this is my first point. Draw a line perpendicular to XY of length equals to 2D. Why 2D? Because 2D is the total length or distance for hexagonal part, and then mark distance of D also. So from this point D up, D down, then D by 2 and D by 2. So D by 2 and D by 2, right? Now from this point the thickness of the bolt head is 0.8D. So from this point mark a distance of 0.8 of D. 0.8 of D is 20 mm for present work. Draw another line parallel to previous line, right? So this is the head. This part is for head. Now from this point, we have to mark length of the bolt and threaded length. So again, from this point, mark a length of 100 mm. Say this is 100 mm, length of the bolt. Then from the last end, from the tail end, 2D plus 6, that is 56. So this is 56. Now this is the range for nut. This is last end and this is first end. Or you can say between these two limits, nut can travel. So we have to project nut within these limits. So we have to start from this point. Say this is my first point, last end of the nut. And from this point, thickness of the nut is small p. So we'll mark a length of D, that is 25 mm. Thickness of the bolt, 0.8D, 20 mm. Thickness of the nut, D, 25 mm. So these are limits for nut. These are extreme limits for threaded length of the bolt. This is tail end. This is last end or last point of the thickness of the head, and this is first end. Now again we have to draw lines from these two ends. Why we are doing this? Because each and every line from the head part can be used directly for nut also, right? And similar to head part, we have to divide this length in 4 equal parts, divide 2, then again divide 2, then divide 2, right? So from first point, from the central point, first face of width D, then extreme upper and lower faces of width divide 2 and divide 2 on both hexagonal headed part and for nut part. Now from these points, draw lines for end faces. And then you can catch it also. Yes. Right. So similar to head part, you can also draw lines for faces of nut. Right. After nut, shank for bolt. So we know that diameter of the bolt is D. So these lines are for major die of bolt, extending them first, and then R, radius for tail. RT is for radius of tail is equals to V is 25 mm for the last end of the tail, and this R is the R for head and bolt. Why I am writing H and V? Because for both radius is 1.5D. So for this part radius is 1.5D, and for nut again radius is 1.5 of D, that is 37.5 mm. So now we know that this part is dark visible part. So from this point, from the last point or last end, tail end, mark distance of 25 mm for center. So from this point distance is 25 mm. This is the center of rotation or center for the radius of last tail end. So this point is center, this much is radius. Draw its tail end, right? Then a vertical line. Then we have to show this length. This line is visible length or visible line for the bolt. This is representing shank, right? After this, we have to decide for its head and nut part. So for head, again, these lines are dark visible lines. This is dark visible. This will be a dark line. This will be a dark line. Right. And for central chamfering, radius is 1.5 of D, 37.5 mm. So for central chamfering, from this point mark center at a distance of 37.5. so this is the center, this is the center for this rotation. So using this center, central arc for chamfering, and then these are my two limits. Just catch them. What is meaning of catching? This will be the distance, right? Now we have three points. First point, second point, and central third point. Passing through these three points, draw a smooth arc for chamfering on extreme edges by trial method. Now what is trial method? Please use rounder, and by trial method, select proper radius for this rotation, right? Now from this point to this point, last end or last line will be a visible line, but we have to think for its chamfering end, chamfering plane or chamfering end. So we'll cover this part after side view. Again, we have to repeat this process for nut. Again, this point is my first point. From this point, mark center. Mark center for central rotation, for central arc at a distance of 1.5. Say this is the center. And from this center, this point as center, this much as radius, 1.5b as radius, draw central chamfering or central arc for chamfering. Now again, we have extreme limits. Catch them and draw arcs like this, right? And then show all visible edges of nut. These are visible sides or edges of the nut, and similarly these are visible edges of bolt. Right, so this is complete projection of front view of hexagonal headed bolt on three faces. So three faces are visible here. Now we have to draw its side view. For side view again, we can catch its limits. So these are extreme limits. So using these limits, now in this combination we have a hexagonal headed bolt, hexagonal nut and a washer, and we are trying to project its side view from this side. This side means this will be the view. So in our side view, we'll have a hexagon, a regular hexagon, chamfering visible circle, and these two circles with dia pointed D and D will be hidden circle. And for representation of external threads on bolt, because bolt part will dominate, so for representation of external threads on bolts, internal circle with dia pointed D will be a incomplete circle or partially interrupted circle. So we have to start from first circle of dia D. These are limits. So drawing a smooth circle of dia D, smooth and complete, right? Then for representation of internal threads, circle with dia pointed D, and please use medium dark pencil. And discontinuity will be on first quadrant, right? Then we have extreme limits of hexagon. So these are extreme limits of hexagon. Now in this case, these are visible faces. So in the side view, first face will be somewhere here. So we'll use these two lines, and this is the length, or this is the edge for the hexagon, and the length is equals to D, right? So the hexagonal part or hexagon of nut and bolt will be a regular hexagon of size D. So for construction of regular hexagon of size D, what to do? We have to start from this corner. These are extreme ends. Sorry, this is the point. So from these two extreme ends, we have to draw lines at an angle of half of central angle. And we know that central angle for hexagon is 120. So from this point, line at an angle of 60. Like this. Again, line at an angle of 60. Similarly, from the top corner, line at an angle of 60 and line at an angle of 60, and then remaining two sides are perpendicular to XY line or parallel to vertical axis. So this is hexagonal part or a regular hexagon, which is representing front view or side view of head part. Now for this hexagon, we have to draw a chamfering circle which will pass through all its midpoints. So what will be the radius from this point, to this point? This is the radius. So this point is center, this much is radius from the center, to the midpoint or point of intersection of first side and horizontal axis. This has radius. Draw a smooth circle passing through all midpoints of the hexagon. Right. So this circle is our chamfering circle. So this is complete projection. Complete projection of hexagonal headed bolt. And the same side view is representing side view of the nut also. So this single figure is representing side view of head and nut. Now after side view, again we have to catch two limits for its chamfering plane. So these are limits. So we have to catch this point. This is the point and this is second point from this point. Yes, so this is the point. And then for head, this is the point, and for second limit, this is the point. Right, so from these four points, what to do? We have to draw lines at an angle of 30 or representation of or for construction of its chamfering plane. At an angle 30, so from this point, angle from this side is 30 and angle is 30. Right. Now this is final visible edge. So we have to show extreme vertical line. Then from this point, chamfering plane like this. So this is complete projection of hexagonal headed bolt with a nut. After this, we have to draw its internal threaded part also. So we have to catch these limits. These are limits for internal thread. We have to mark this right up to this point and second limit for internal thread with dia 0.8D. Yes. So from this point, okay, before that, vertical line from the last end, I think this is last end. Yes, this is the last end. So from this point, for internal threads, draw lines up to threaded. Then at an angle of 45, touching outer dia. So these two lines are now representing its internal threads. In this we have to show by dark pencil. Now it is complete. And please remember, these points are also on the extreme edge. So this is final. Now we have to draw its top view also. So for top view, what we have to do is we'll project its end limits for top view and from side view. So for top view, first is we'll project its limit for hexagonal head. Then we can use its central locus also, but end of thread can be used. And then from these points, angle is 45. So angle 45. This angle is 45. And then lines parallel to first edge or reference XY line. Yes. Now using locus from front view and side view, we can draw its top view. So we'll start from the first point. Say this is my first point. This is my first point. This is extreme end or corner for its head. So this is first point. This is second point. This is third point, and this is fourth point. Similarly for nut, these are four points, and these are ends of. These are ends of bolt tail end. So we'll start from this side. This is bolt. This is nut. Right. And shank part. Shank for bolt. These are limits with dia D. Dia D. And dia D. Then this is the last end, and again we have to mark center for this rotation. Set a distance of D, mark center, and radius equals to D tail end. Right. And then we have limits for its threaded end also. So using internal thread limits up to threaded length. This is thread length or range for threaded length. We have to show internal threads also. Right. Now nut and head. For top view, only two faces will be visible. So central face or central edge. For two faces will be a visible edge. Next, for chamfering on faces, again we have to catch its limit from front view. So these are limits. These are limits. We have to catch it. We have to catch it for top view. Right. So now we have limits. First limit, second limit, and central is third limit. First limit, second limit, and third limit. So passing through these three points, draw a smooth arc for chamfering by trial method. So you have to decide proper radius and center for this part. Now front view, top view, and side view is ready. If the question is related to hexagonal headed bolt and nut, then this will be the final answer. Front view, top view, and side view of hexagonal headed bolt with hexagonal nut. Now if we add washer, internal dia of washer D plus 1, 25 plus 1, 26 mm, external dia of washer 2D plus 3 or 2D plus 4. So 2D plus 4 is better, 54 mm and washer thickness D by 8. Here capital D is 25 mm. So D by 8 is 3.125. So for construction we'll go for 3 mm. So these are dimensions of washer. So we have to add washers in front view, top view and in side view. So for washer, first is from the central end we have to mark its dia or limits of diameter 2D plus 4, 54. So half of 54 from central line and half of 54 from central line downwards direction. And thickness. Thickness is 3 mm. 3 mm. And we have to repeat this for top view because it's a circular or cylindrical ring. So the view from the front and from the top will be same, exactly same. So front view and top view of the washer will be same. And now in the side view, we have to draw a circle. So circle representing side view of washer with dia 54 mm. Right. So a smooth circle of dia 54 mm. So, this is the complete projection of hexagonal headed bolt with hexagonal nut and washer in front view, top view and side view. Next dimensioning, starting from its chamfering plane and it is 30, this angle is also 30. Angle is 30. Now this is D, this dia is D, diameter D, and this is point D. Right. So after dimensioning, next is table for standard dimensions. So please draw table for standard dimensions. Right, so we have D, right, D point A is also representing its thickness of the bolt, capital T, 1.5D, 2D, 2D plus 6, L is 4D, D plus 1 internal IF for washer, external IF for washer 2D plus 4, and D by 8. Last right, its heading, hexagonal headed bolt with hexagonal nut and washer. Right, hexagonal bolt with hexagonal nut and washer, or hexagonal bolt with hexagonal nut and washer, or assembly of hexagonal headed bolt with hexagonal nut and washer. Now I request you to please draw this problem on your sheet, starting from front view, then side view, then top view, with washer or without washer as per the problem statement. Then do proper dimensioning, then standard table and its naming, and if you have time, enough time, then write headings of front view, top view and side view also. So this is all from my side. Now if you have any problem, any doubt in engineering graphics or machine drawing, please write your comments in the comment box. Thank you.